The only idea that we do not agree with is the notion that we should take investment arbitration out of TTIP altogether. First of all, of course, the United States is a functioning democracy based on the rule of law. But that does not mean that there is no risk to investors. US courts are not obliged to follow commitments that the US take internationally. And the US does not always respect the international commitments. The US has the most US WTO cases against it or than any other WTO member. What you have in front of you is not a legal text. And that's on purpose, because we wanted to have your input before we move to the next step of the process internally in the Commission and sets out a legal proposal.
Madame la Commissaire, merci d'être là. Je ne vous cache pas mon extraordinaire déception à la lecture de votre papier. Je suis désolé, madame, mais dans votre proposition, vous ne faites toujours pas la démonstration de savoir pourquoi il faut ISDS entre l'Europe et le Canada, ISDS entre l'Europe et les États-Unis. Il n'y a toujours pas cette démonstration. La Banque mondiale, l'OCDE disent pas besoin d'ISDS pour augmenter les flux d'investissement. Vous avez même, votre direction a sorti un rapport sur l'accord avec la Corée du Sud. Vous dites, formidable, il y a plus d'investissement, mais il n'y a pas d'ASDS dans l'accord avec la Corée du Sud. Donc, au fond, vous n'arrivez toujours pas à démontrer la nécessité de ce dispositif. Vous pouvez dire ce que vous voulez, un avocat d'affaires, ça n'est pas un juge. Un avocat d'affaires, ça n'est pas un juge. Ce n'est pas en privatisant une partie de la justice et de nos choix de société tels qu'ils vont être comparés, mis en confrontation avec le droit des affaires, ce n'est pas en faisant ça qu'on redonne de la valeur, du poids au processus démocratique. Ici, il doit y avoir une cour permanente. Ce n'est pas dans le long terme, une fois qu'on aura mis un ISDS qui donnera tout le pouvoir aux firmes multinationales, gardons les systèmes juridiques nationaux, travaillons à une cour permanente comme première étape d'un tribunal international, et là on aura fait de la démocratie, on aura servi les intérêts de l'Europe. Merci.
If you're saying that the long-term view is to create this international courts, does that mean that there will be a sunset clause for ISDS in TTIP, CETA and Singapore, or how are we going to phase out those then-existing ISDS if, clauses if there's a new court? Another question is, which is not entirely ISDS, but sustainable impact assessment. We hear somehow on the corridors that one has been made, but it's not public yet. When are you going to publish the sustainable impact assessment on TTIP? And furthermore, I would just like to stress that the proposals that you have made do not at all address the core problem of ISDS as I see it, namely that ISDS creates an extra judicial system for investors, and it's only about the rights of investors. No person can address redress to an investor when their human rights are being violated, and that happens a lot, be it in Latin America and be it elsewhere in the world. So how are we going to address those? I think ISDS is just creating an extrajudicial system for investors, for certain investors only, and it should not have any space in our legal system in the European Union.
On Canada and on ISDS, as I said, we have made important, and you have all, many of you have been involved in that, changes that are now reflected in the ISDS in Canada and Singapore. Both these agreements are closed. We are not going to open the agreements. On the Sustainable Development Pact, was Mrs. Keller as well, who asked that. It is working. We are consulting a lot with it, so it's not ready yet. And I cannot give you an exact date. It will be later in the fall. It's not ready yet, yes. So let me come back when we are moving. But it's a lot of data and a lot of consultants that we are doing on this. Well, the issue of a sunset clause or something, as Mrs. Keller raised, that's a good question. I don't have the answer to that, but I'll take it with me.